Hi, I'm Max and welcome to Topped Out, a feature where I talk and explain different things in cars and car culture. Now I know a lot of you may not be that into cars, you just see it as a vehicle to get you from point A to point B, but for many people it's almost like a way of life. So to start things off nice and easy, I'm going to be doing something I like to call modified mistakes. I'll be going on Facebook Marketplace trying to find the most cursed cars I can, and then either voting if they're hot or not. First one up, something easy, smooth compared to the others. A limousine that seems to have a front end swap of a Camaro. Yeah, that just, it shouldn't exist. But either way, its paint job's nice, it's nice and smooth, the body kind of fits. So I'd have to rate this one as a hot for sure. I'd drive this if I had it. Then the next one is a Chevy S10. I have no idea what decided to make them sell this on Facebook Marketplace, but it looks like they just took the back of a school bus and crammed it onto a Chevy. It's just, it's a mess. Like, and the paint job, the white tearing off with the rust, it just, it makes it look like something you'd see just out in like hillbilly country or something. Like, oh, come on kids, let's get in the van. Like, what? You have like 20 kids you need to fit in the back of your truck? That's a little concerning. I have to vote this one definitely not. No way I'd drive this anywhere. Next up, this one just pained me to find. Once I found it, I'm like, this should not exist, and it honestly just makes me cringe all the way to my bones. It's a Honda Civic. And it looks like somebody just decided to take a Sawzall to the back seats and the trunk and just cover it up with like the bed of a truck. So basically it's a homemade pickup Honda Civic. And what's even worse is the hood exhaust, or the bumper exhaust, I guess, just held on by the license plate. Just makes me want to, oh my gosh, it just.
Good morning, this is your accent for Monday, September 13th. I'm Vanessa Girard, here with Xavier Geisinger. Let's get it started.
Hey seniors, college representatives will be visiting our school during this month and next. Please be sure to check your email from final forms to see who's coming. You can also check the bulletin board for updates outside of the guidance office. Please stop and see Mrs. Elder or email her if you're interested.
Auditions are today and tomorrow in the auditorium immediately after school for the fall play. Junie B. Jones is not a crook. Come and try out. If you need more details, please see Mrs. Erickson in room A221.
To all juniors, now is the time to sign up to take the PSAT. The test will be administered on Wednesday, October 13th in the Media Center. The cost is $18. Please stop down to see Mrs. Elder in the guidance office to pay for your test. Mrs. Elder will accept cash or a check made out to the Maslin Board of Education. This test is first come, first serve. See Mr. Marceric with questions.
Hey students, if you are interested in being part of the Spanish Club this year, please come to their first meeting, which is tomorrow, September 14th at 2:10 in room C204, Mrs. Petro's room. Future meetings will be on the second Tuesday of each month. Hasta pronto.
The Tiger golf team moved to 10-3 on the season after beating Tuslaw last Thursday afternoon. Team leaders were Brock Jenkins with a 35 and Trent Marsh with a 38. Our Tiger golfers are back in action today at the Worcester Invitational at Worcester Country Club.
Winter is just around the corner, and that means winter sports are too. Anyone interested in trying out for the swim team should attend a quick meeting after school tomorrow at 2:05 in Coach Dye's room, room D206.
Today's lunch is a walking taco, assorted toppings, refried beans, salsa, corn, and fruit.
Happy birthday to Summer Stern and Ayanna Sullivan.
Well, that's all for your accent. I'm Xavier, here with Vanessa. Take it easy, and we'll see you Wednesday.